So I'm Yogesh Rawat, currently an assistant professor in Center for Research in Computer Vision at UCF. And today I will cover some of the research projects I've been doing, which are focused on deep learning for computer vision and multimedia. So a bit of introduction. So this is me. And I did my PhD from National University of Singapore. After that, I joined CRCV at UCF for my postdoc. And after that, I started assistant professor position at CRCV. This was last October. And my research focus is on computer vision, multimedia, and how we can use deep learning to solve problems in these two areas. So currently, I don't have any PhD students. And so these are the PhD students from CRCV with whom I'm currently working. So one of my research focus is on visual understanding. And one of the application is in surveillance. So we have surveillance cameras everywhere, like outdoors, indoors. And the way these are like monitored is we have a security personnel watching at these security feeds, multiple streams at a time. It's like challenging for a person to do. It's like straining. It can cause some sleep. So it's not very efficient thing to do. So we want to automate this process. And so doing this like at human level is very challenging. So we are trying to focus on different aspects of this automatic analysis. And other applications of visual understanding apart from surveillance are like in robotics, and it can be used also for self-driving cars. So one of the area we are focusing on is activity detection, which does like given a video, if you can detect what's happening in that video. The other problem we are focusing on is video segmentation, whether we can detect objects which are present in the video and track them over time. So other related problems are video classification, and the other area which you're interested in is video synthesis. So apart from visual understanding, my other focus is on multimodal learning. And the motivation is, so apart from these CCTV cameras, we do have like these mobile phones which have these cameras. We capture lots of photos, lots of videos, share them on social media. So the good thing about this is, these images and videos, we don't just have the visual information. There is a lot of contextual information as well, such as the location, like where these photos and images, photos and videos were captured. And we do have information like comments from different users. So the idea here is, can we use all of this contextual information to improve the visual understanding? So some of the problems which we can solve using this is event extraction from this unstructured data. We can use this kind of data for user preference learning. And then we can use that learned preference for recommendation and other problems. So I will cover some of the projects which currently I'm focusing on. The first one I will start with is real-time activity detection in videos. So the idea here is, if we have a long security video, can we detect all the activities happening in that video? And the approach we have developed is a deep learning framework, which is 3D convolution based. And we are taking two-step process, and we are doing this in an online fashion, which means that we don't have to like see the future to detect any activity. So we detect the activity as it is happening. This like shows a network architecture we have developed. So what happens is we have this input video coming as input. We localize where the activities are happening in that video. Then we extract like those activities and try to predict what are those activities and to make the final predictions. So the system we have developed, it's a real-time online system, which runs at 100 frames per second, which is like 3 times faster than real-time. And we participated in an active challenge in CVPR 2020, and the system was a winner there. We presented this work last month. And this is a link like for the presentation. So here I will show like a small demo, which shows what the system can do. So this is a security feed. And so like this is an activity happening, a car is turning left. So the system can detect this. And even if there are multiple activities happening at the same time, so for example, this one, it can localize those activities and also detect. So just to note, this is not just like detecting vehicles or detecting cars, it's detecting vehicles as well as classifying what kind of activity that vehicle is involved in. So it could be vehicle turning left or vehicle turning right. So just to give you a reference, in this challenge, there were multiple groups like top computer vision groups, which participated, like IBM, CMU, UMD. And we had like the system had the best performance, not just in terms of the evaluation metric, but it was like faster than most of the other systems. So the other project I want to talk about is about capsule networks, which we have been working on for a while. And the idea is we want to tackle the issues of the traditional convolutional neural networks, the limitations which it has. So one of the biggest limitation of these traditional CNNs is they don't model the entity relationships. So we want to tackle that problem using this 3D capsules. We are mainly developing this for videos, like where we have 3D data. And again, this is a deep learning network which can be trained end to end. So one of the main focus here is like how we can minimize the memory utilization of such a network so that we can train these efficiently. And we have developed like some techniques to do that. I will briefly cover those. And we're also exploring the use of these capsules in multimodal kind of data. So this is like the network architecture which we have developed to solve like video understanding problem. And here the novelty is like this capsule pooling and this sharing of transformation matrices, which actually enforces how we can train these networks very efficiently with a very less amount of memory. So just to give you a context, so if you will have a face image, the traditional CNN will easily detect this is a face, and capsules can also do that. But if you pass this image to a traditional CNN, what will happen is, since all the entities which are required to represent a face, such as eyes and nose, are present here, it will recognize this as face, so which is not right. And the reason it does that is because it's not learning the relationship between these entities which are required like to actually construct a face. So this kind of issues can be easily fixed with capsules. So what we have done is we have tried these developed capsules for different problems in video, and we have found them very effective for video understanding. So one of the problems was action detection, where we observed like around 20% improvement compared to like state of the art, which is very impressive. So these are like some of the results from that system. The red box is like the ground truth. The blue is the detected activity. So you can see like most of the cases it's doing the right job. We also tested this for video segmentation. So for video segmentation, we have to detect all the objects, and it's like pixel wise segmentation, and we have to track that along time. So these are a couple of examples. So we can see that these are really nice segmentations. So the other problem where we have used these capsules is text-based segmentation. And the idea here is if we have a video and some activity is happening, if we describe that activity in textual form, like there is a baby playing, so if you say baby sitting on the ground, then we can segment just that baby. So the system can do that as well. So moving forward, so the next research I've been focusing on is extracting sub-activities from a complex activity which might be happening in a long video. And the object here is, if you have lots of videos which are like unstructured without any annotations, can we extract some kind of knowledge from those videos? So we don't want to use any kind of labels, and there can be multiple modalities as well. So in this direction, we are developing two approaches. One is weakly supervised, where we use text along with video. The other is just unsupervised. We just use the videos without using any annotations. So one of the network we have developed is like an autoencoder. Given a video, this network can detect what all sub activities are happening in this video. So just to give you an idea, if you have this video where someone is cooking maybe some dish, so it's a complex activity because lots of sub-actions are required to complete this procedure, and these sub-actions can be in different order. So in each video, it will be different. So without using any annotations, can we detect these sub-actions? And we have found that, yeah, it can be done effectively with the method we have developed. And the good thing is we don't need any kind of labels for this. It can be done in a weakly supervised fashion as well if we have text along with the video. And we have shown that it improves the quality of that detection. So this is showing one such example where the person is, I think, making a sandwich, and these different colors are for different sub-actions which were detected for this activity. Now, the other representation which we can extract from these long videos is a graphical representation, which is easily interpretable. Here we are showing some examples of these complex activities. And so each of these graphs represent this activity, and the node in the graph is like the sub-action. and the edges are the relation between those subactions, how they are like occurring along time. So this is like a more interpretable form. So moving on to the next project, the idea here is if we have lots of visual data from social media data, so from social media, then can we learn some kind of user preference which can be used for recommendations? And the problem we are trying to solve here is like, can we recommend user tags given an image based on user preferences? So we developed a method like where we are doing joint learning. We are using both user preference and visual for solving this task. That's the network we have developed. So what it does is given an input image, if we know user history, what kind of tags he has used in the past, what it will do is it will recommend some of the tags for this given input image. So just to give you an idea, so you can see like these two images, the visual information is almost similar. So if you don't use user preference, any deep network or any learning-based method will recommend similar kind of tags. But the issue will be those tags might not be relevant to all the users at the same time. So different users might assign different tags to these images. And the idea here is, can we learn that user preference which can be used for such a recommendation? And the good thing about this approach is we don't need any annotations. We are just using free annotations which are available online. So it's saving lots of cost and time as well. And we also showed that this can be done at a large scale. So we tested this system on a data set where we have around 100 million images. So that's really impressive. And this one just showing one example where if we have different users with different tagging preference, we can recommend different kind of tags to those two users. So looking ahead, my short-term goal is to further explore this web-based learning because it's more efficient. There's lots of data available in the internet. We don't have to like spend time and money in doing annotations. And the good thing is we can get like multiple modalities from this kind of data. And the biggest challenge is this kind of data come with noise. So we have to handle noise while performing the learning. So apart from that, I'm also focusing on video synthesis. And so this is like results from some preliminary results from one of the projects we are doing. The idea here is if we have a video of a person performing some action, can we synthesize the same action from an unseen view? So we have some pretty good preliminary results and we are exploring this further. The other projects I'm looking into is like view invariance. Again, this is, can we learn a representation for a video if we have that video from an unseen view? So these two are kind of correlated. And I'm actively looking for collaborations. So for long-term goal, I want to develop like visual understanding methods where we don't need any annotations. We want to do that in an unsupervised way where we don't have any labels for the videos. We want to do that in a self-supervised fashion and want to explore more in this multimodal learning area. And I want to diversify like to other areas where vision can help. All right, that's it. Thank you.
All right, thanks, sir.